presenting you the concept of newborn screening. And I'm sure most of you must have heard about newborn screening in this country. And I'm sure you are also practicing it in your day-to-day practice. But unfortunately, India, it is still not yet taken up as we expected. So you may be asking me why we should do newborn screening and what are the benefits? And the next question also is that it is very expensive. So these are the three things which we need to answer why we need to do a newborn screening. So with this, I would like to take you on to a few of the aspects of newborn screening, what we are doing in India, and what is to be done in future. So the newborn screening, as you all know, this is a pre-symptomatic test on all the newborns, and where the newborn is not really affected with any disease. So if you pick up this particular condition at this stage and offer management of this condition, you are going to make the child live a near normal or a mostly a normal life, and you are giving the child a normal life. But if you don't treat them, the child can manifest critical features, manifestations, and end up with severe morbidity and mortality later on. So that is the reason why we need to pick them up very early in life and pre-symptomatic treatment of these conditions. In all the Western countries, this particular program has become a part of the healthcare system. But unfortunately, in India, we have a very high birth rate and high frequency of metabolic disorders. Newborn screening has not really taken up, and it is not a part of the healthcare system at present. So looking at the knowledge, what we have about the inborn errors or the metabolic disorders, although we don't have a very large data on the prevalence of these disorders, but we have established already by doing a lot of screening programs, pilot programs on the newborns, and also screening children who are at risk for any high-risk children. And we found that these disorders are at a very high prevalence in our population. So this is the study which helped us to go through what are called the newborn screening in India. Just the first screening was started way back in 1980s, and screening about 125,000 newborns in the state of Karnataka, which was done by me. And then we established the prevalence of amino acid disorders in our population. At that time, we never thought that we have the amino acid disorders existing, but this particular study has shown a prevalence of amino acid disorders. Subsequently, after that, we have gone into the next level of screening, which are called the expanded screening. And here again, we have a very good data that has come up that showed a very high prevalence of certain treatable disorders in the population. And coming to, at the same time, we also did the other level of screening, at which time the tandem mass screening was available in 2006. So we also showed at that time that newborns and older children are affected with a large number of these organic acid disorders. Then came the multicentric trial, which is set up by the Indian Council of Medical Research way back in 2007 and 2012. And we studied this particular disorder, two of the most common disorders which were earlier identified, the congenital hypothyroidism and congenital adrenal hyperplasia in our population. And five centers in the country were studied. A total of 100,000 newborns and high-risk children were evaluated under the task force research program of the Indian Council of Medical Research. Of course, then came the other aspects, that is the utilization of the National Health Mission to do the screening programs in various centers, as well as presently newborn screening has been introduced in certain states in the country, namely in Goa. Goa is the first country to start the newborn screening, and now Kerala has started for few disorders. Chennai and Vellore also have started, and newborn screening is going on in Lucknow as well as in Chandigarh. So these are again a few state-owned programs that are going on now, and we need to expand this further so that all babies will be benefited by this screening. So what did this study give? The outcome of the first newborn screening has shown that we have large number of babies that are affected with amino acid disorders, namely the maple syrup urine disease, the phenylketonuria, the tyrosinemias, then the glycine encephalopathies. All these disorders were present, and this was the first report that came out from the Indian study. Then come the expanded program has shown a very large proportion of our babies were affected with congenital hypothyroidism to the extent of 1 in 1700 births. So this shows the prevalence is very, very high in our population. And then even the congenital adrenal hypoplasia is also quite high in 1 in 2600 population, followed by galactosemia. G6PD deficiency is very, very high in our population. And different regions of the country, the incidence varies. And we also found a large number of babies having biotinidase deficiency. As you can see, these disorders, large number of these disorders are treatable. Only thing is we need to identify them before organ damage has taken place in the child. So the next screening program which we did show, the tandem mass spectrometry for the organic acid disorders and fatty acid oxidation disorders, with a very high prevalence of organic acid disorders to the extent of 1 in 1,000 babies born. And this is alarmingly high in our population. So this has the basis that has set up for the ICMR to set up this screening program, and it is again showing a very high prevalence of congenital hypothyroidism to the extent of 1,100 babies born. And then the G6PD also is quite high, the congenital adrenal hyperplasia is also high to the extent of 1 in 5,000 babies born. And so we looked into the high-risk babies also all over the country, and we demonstrated that in all parts of the country, we have IEMs present in high-risk children with more of organic acid disorders and followed by amino acid disorders. So this is the region-wise distribution of the disorders. And when we look at the high-risk stratified screening, we again found the organic acids forming the major chunk of the disease that is seen in newborns, and the commonest being the methylmalonic aciduria and glutaric aciduria, which are again treatable conditions if you can pick them up early in life. And when you look at the age of manifestation, most of them have been seen, as you can see, in the infancy, newborn period, and in the infant. So this is the period at which you should pick them up and see best of the treatment is given to these children. And when you look at the outcome of these children, the outcome is very bad if it is diagnosed late in life, and the outcome is good if you manage them. And we have shown about 28% of these children have benefited with the management. So this shows how important it is to do newborn screening in the country in order to manage this sort of cases in your practice. So the other important thing is the congenital hearing loss, and this is again very common in our country. With estimated 8 in 1,000 newborns screened, and so this is another thing which we need to look into all the newborns for hearing loss, and this is very important because early recognition and intervention will help the child and the family a long way in managing the congenital hearing loss. So this, with this thing, what is it we have learned from these things is that the morbidity and mortality of our children with IEM is high because of delayed diagnosis and no newborn screening. If you have newborn screening, you could have picked them up very early and you could have treated them. And we know that there is a high prevalence of IEMs in the pediatric age, and those children where you have given the treatment, they have done very well, and the large number of diagnosed children sometimes are lost to follow-up right now. This is because most of the practicing physicians, they're not aware of how to manage these children with regard to the diet nor the medicines. And so they do give a negative counseling. That's the reason why we lose these children. But you remember that if you can pick them up early in life and start giving the management, they really do very well, which we have been doing for the last few years in our country. And then the present status, what is the status? The Indian Academy of Pediatrics has celebrated the golden jubilee of the commencement of newborn screening in way back in 2013. But unfortunately, till now, it is not implemented. In a few states, as I told you, they have started screening. But of course, we have seen many of the private and corporate hospitals and also some in the government sector are running their own programs. But I want every one of us to do this newborn screening and help the child as well as the family. And today I would like to tell you that this is no more a genetic or a high specialty subject, but this is now a part and parcel of neonatology and pediatric management. Then when other developed countries have designed their own policies and mandated newborn screening, India is not yet implemented newborn screening, not even for a single disorder. It is so unfortunate. Even Pakistan and Nepal have started newborn screening, but we have not started screening all our babies. The burden of disease, as I told you, is very high. The congenital hypothyroidism, 1 in 1,100. It is much higher than any other reported incidence in the world. And so we need a mandatory screening for congenital hypothyroidism. It is now the need of the hour, and the pediatricians and neonatologists, they also fail to educate the administrators to include newborn screening in what is called the Rashtriya Bal Swasthya Karyakramam, where they would like to identify children with disabilities and then defective hearing and well-established hypothyroidism. But is there any need to manage such children because they are already damaged? So it is always prevention is better than cure. And so it is meaningful to use this particular program under the National Health Mission to start the newborn screening in the country and see that our newborn screening goes very well. And I am sure we have all the expertise available in the country to manage these cases. And we also have the special formula medical diets that are required for the management of these children in the country. These are now being made in the country. We need not import these formula diets anymore presently. So IEMs are common in India. It's also due to prevalence of high degree of consanguinity. Apart from consanguinity, we also has what is called endogamy. This is an indirect inbreeding because we tend to marry within our own communities, our own people. So this is called the indirect community, so consanguinity. So the chances of the genes coming together will be quite high in these type of marriages. So the states that are doing the newborn screening is the Goa Heal to Heal program, the Chandigarh, and then the few states in Kerala and Chennai, Vellore in South Africa. So I just would like to tell you, before this is implemented, universal newborn screening, at least screen those babies who are born to parents who are consanguineous and who come to you with a neonatal sickness. They should be screened in the newborn period, even without symptoms, and consider this as a mandatory screening in clinical practice for all these type of babies and families. Then these are some of the recommendations that are given for the implementation of the program. And then The newborn screening is an important public health program aimed to detect inborn errors early in life to prevent intellectual disability. And with the advent of tandem mass screening, number of disorders can be diagnosed and newborn screening to be implemented on par with immunization and cover the whole newborn population. So my slogan for newborn screening is a drop of blood that saves, a drop that protects, and a test that keeps a baby healthy and alive. And that is newborn screening. And it is the time to revive ourselves now so as to rejoice later. So this is the day I expect to come that every baby says that I thank my mom and dad and my neonatologist and pediatrician that I am screened. And let us do it for the future generations and make it successful like immunization. Thank you very much.